Hello everybody, this is Agent Kak. This is part 2, as the title clearly says. So, be sure to watch part 1 first, if you did not already. In episode 3, we are on our way to Mars when we are attacked by our enemies. Lily doesn't deem them a threat, so we'll just ignore them. So, after talking to Koji, Toria feels a little bit more enthusiastic about fighting. Not a lot, but hey, it's some character development. Time for a comedy scene! So wait, Akato... Akato is watching guys anime? Why is he right indeed? So, while we're talking about the science of Mars, the Nadesco becomes under attack. But this one is not interactive. So, we'll just sit back and listen to the ship's speakers what's going on. After landing on Mars, Eureka discovered that everybody on Mars is not dead, and that there were some survivors. Hooray! A whole 6 survivors. Hooray. So, after a quite disappointing story about what happened to the non-survivors, meet the hero of the survivors. Oh wow, he has a robot too. What are the odds? And to be sure to tie all the storylines together, we are told that we can't fight the plants and the Jovian lizards by ourselves. Time for a crossover. Wait, isn't this whole game one big crossover? SPOILER ALERT! Because we didn't run from our enemy attack, our engines are fried. Also, it would appear that sadly, to save ourselves, we killed all the remaining survivors. Yes, this does suck. But on the plus side, Toya now has the motivation to fight. Within all the weaklings in there, there's somebody important. Somebody who thinks Edgy is a traitor to Mars. And thanks to my upgrading, my army platoon of robotic mechanists is getting stronger. I was just a little bit too early with me saying Gravity Blast there. Is this a one-hit kill? One-hit kill! Punch! 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 Kick! Stronger and larger. With my army getting so large, it's difficult to keep track of everything. Hopefully, I will find a menu shortcut soon. But, if not, I have a good excuse. I'm still kind of learning, like, the concepts of this game that I still don't know about. Disappointment occurred when, for the first time, my gravity blast failed. You avoid my gravity blast. God damn it. And, to make matters worse, I lost my first unit. Shit. So, is he forever dead? Ding 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 ding. It's time for a showdown, everybody. Edgy versus Gale. Oh, who will win? Gale attacks with his beam rifle. Oh, critical hit. And Edgy counters with his own laser pistol. Can Edgy survive? Luckily, Maluna is aboard Cowswell and can heal him for 2,000 HP. Okay. It would seem that I forgot about another special unit, the Dermage. Even these battles can get somewhat long and drawn out. Yes, I do admit these battles do get kind of boring at times, and I still find ways to make them fun. This should get it. Twin Lancer, the final blow! Hell yeah, explode. Oh, strike! Whirlwind head attack! Time to end the battle with negotiations. Negotiations failed. Back to fighting again. And, with his defeat, he called a full-scale retreat, which at this point was just one lone cotton bow and himself. All units! Replacing Gale on the battlefield is Lieutenant Gostero. Now, there is a major difference between these two opponents. Gostero would prefer to murder my entire fleet rather than just stopping us in the name of justice. After the fight with Gale and his forces, some of my units aren't in the best of condition, so another casualty isn't really out of the question. Fuck. So I lost Sayaka. But, on the plus side, you can see that my planning skills are getting a bit, just a bit, mind you, better. Okay. That should kind of protect me. And it would seem that I'm slowly improving. What? What's that? Time for comedy? Okay! Oh, Noel, you and your candy bars. Don't you just hate it when a plan backfires? I do.
What the cliffside looks like. Yeah, I put up the wall because he was surrounded by 4 soldiers, and yet they all just escaped. And, I mean, not escaped, I mean, like, didn't choose to attack him.
Also, finding the right place to attack from can be so hard sometimes.
But if I'm on these rocks, I cannot use U.S. Hurricane.
After Edgy gets defeated, it's time for a change of strategy. But I'm going to send everybody up to... what's his name? Like, Guy's replacement. Not Guy's replacement. What's his name? No, Gale's replacement guy. Gostero. And I'm going to, like... fuck up his day. Or something.
Fighting Gostero seems to be so tricky. Since he was avoiding everything I threw at him since the beginning. Eventually, he took a few hits.
Lasers! And missiles.
But then, I decided to pull out the big guns with a surprising result.
I will finish this with style. Super Gravity Blast! I've never seen this one in action before. Holy shit!
Finally, Toya lands the finishing blow and sends Gostero packing, and it seems that we're not on good terms with the Gosterian army. Most likely, they'll be back. Most likely, for revenge. Back on the Nadesco, it is confirmed that everybody who lived on Mars is now dead. But there's no time to be depressed, Akato has to cheer up Eureka. Playing the puzzle robo puzzles is really improving my knowledge how this game works. Also, more upgrading.
Okay, everybody, this concludes part 2. Stay tuned for future parts, okay? Until then, this is Agent Kak, and I'm saying adios.